Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss exercise 3.4 from pair of linear equations in two variables. We will solve the problems using elimination method.
We have two equations, 3x plus 4y is equal to 10. I will take it as first equation, and 2x minus 2y is equal to 2. I will assume it as second equation. The first step of elimination method is we have to convert either x quotient or y quotient numerically equal. If you see this question, both x first equation and second equation, either x quotients are equal nor y quotients are same. So what I will do is I will convert y quotient same by multiplying with second equation with 2. Why I am multiplying second equation with 2 is to convert y quotient 2 to 4, I have to multiply 2 with 2. So 2 2s are 4. So I will rewrite the both equation once again. So 3x plus 4y is equal to 10, and the converted equation is 2 2s are 4x minus 2y into 2 is minus 4y and 2 2s are 4. So we have to arrange the both equation in such a way x quotient, y quotient and numbers should be one below the other. Now I am going to add both equations. If you add both equation, plus 4y minus 4y get eliminated. As y is eliminated, this method is called elimination method. So I am going to add both equation. 3x plus 4x is 7x and 10 plus 4 is 14. Now this is a linear equation with one variable. Now I am going to solve this linear equation. 7x is equal to 14. X will become 14 by 7, which is nothing but 2. Once I got the x value, I am going to substitute this x value in either first equation or second equation. It is the last step of elimination method. I am going to substitute x is equal to 2 in first equation. What is first equation, students? 3x plus 4y is equal to 10. So we know the value of x, which is 2, and replacing the other terms as it is. 3 2s are 6 plus 4y is equal to 10. Now simple calculations, 4y is equal to 10 minus 6, which is nothing but 4. Y is equal to 4 by 4, which is equal to 1. Therefore, y is equal to 1 and x is equal to 2. We'll see the steps of elimination method once again, students. First, convert either x quotient or y quotient numerically equal. Second step is we have to eliminate either x or y. In this question, we have eliminated y quotient, which are same. Third step is we have to solve linear equation in one variable to get x value. In this question, we got x value as 2. It is the third step in elimination method. Final and last step in elimination method is we have to substitute this x value either in first equation or second equation. We have replaced it in first equation and we got the value of y. These four are the steps involved in elimination method. Now we are going to solve pair of linear equation in elimination method by eliminating x. So we'll take 3x plus 4y is equal to 10 as first equation and 2x minus 2y is equal to 2 as second equation. So to convert this x quotient same, I have to multiply first equation with 2 and second equation with 3. So first equation quotient is 3. So we have to multiply second equation with 3. Second equation x quotient is 2. We have to multiply first equation with 2. So now rewriting the equations, we will get 3x into 2 is 6x, 4y into 2 is 8y. And 10 into 2 is 20. Now we will rewrite the second equation. 2x into 3 is 6x. Minus 2y into 3 is minus 6y. 2 times 3 is 6. So we have to arrange x quotient, y quotient and numericals one below the other. Now we will add or subtract based on the quotients. Now both the first equation and second equation symbols are same. So we are going to do subtraction. If while subtraction, the symbols will be changed. Plus will become minus, minus will become plus, and plus will become minus. So plus 6x minus 6x we are eliminating by in subtraction. So as we are eliminating, as I told, this is a elimination method. So 8y plus 6y is 14y, 20 minus 6 is 14. So this is the variable, this is the linear equation in one variable, and we are going to solve it. So 14y is equal to 14, y is equal to 1. So now we are going to substitute this y is equal to 1 either in first equation or second equation. So we will substitute y is equal to 1 in first equation. What is first equation, students? 3x plus 4y is equal to 10. So we got y value as 1. So I am replacing y with 1 and remaining terms keeping as it is. 4 times 1 is 4 is equal to 10. So 3x is equal to 10 minus 4, which is nothing but 6. So x is equal to 6 by 3 value is 2. So x is equal to 2. In the previous method also we got x is equal to 2 and y is 1. In this method also we got y is equal to 1 and x is equal to 2. Y is equal to 1 in second equation. Earlier we replaced y is equal to 1 in first equation. We got x is equal to 2. And we are going to cross check the same y is equal to 1 in second equation. So second equation is 2x minus 2y is equal to 2. So we know the y value, which is nothing but 1. I am replacing 1. So 2x, 2 1 the 2, which is equal to 2. 2x is equal to 2, minus 2 moves to the other side will become plus 2. 2x is equal to 4, x is equal to 4 by 2, x is equal to 2. So we got the same answer if we replace the y value 1 in first equation and second equation.
In second question, we form pair of linear equation and solve them using elimination method. Second question, first bit. If we add 1 to the numerator and subtract 1 from the denominator, a fraction reduces to 1. It becomes 1 by 2 if we add only 1 to the denominator. What is the fraction?
We are going to find the fraction in this problem. As we don't know fraction, let us state fraction is equal to x by y. So the condition for this question is, there are two conditions, students. First condition, 1 is added to the numerator. In fraction x by y, x is numerator and y is denominator. 1 is added to the numerator and 1 is subtracted from the denominator. So 1 is subtracted means y minus 1 and the equation becomes 1. So this is the condition given in the question. Now we are going to follow few steps and convert this condition into first equation. Let us follow the few steps. So x plus 1 is equal to y minus 1 into 1 is y minus 1 itself. We will convert all the variables one side. X plus y moves to the other side will become minus y. And I will retain minus 1 in the right hand side as it is. Plus 1 goes to the other side. It will become minus 1. So x minus y is equal to minus 1 minus 1 becomes minus 2. And I will assume this one as first equation. Now there is a second condition in the question. 1 is added to the denominator, only denominator. So I am retaining numerator as it is. I am keeping numerator as it is and adding 1 to the denominator and the equation becomes 1 by 2. As the fractions are equated, we have to do the cross multiplication. 2 into x is 2x. Y plus 1 into 1 is y plus 1 itself. Now we will bring all the variables to one side. 2x plus y goes to the other side, minus y. So 1. And I will treat it as second equation. Now I got first equation and second equation. Now I am going to solve this two equation using elimination method. We all know elimination method, right? First we have to eliminate either x or y. So x minus y is equal to minus 2 and 2x minus y is equal to 1. I have to arrange the terms in such a way x coefficients or y variables and numbers should be one below the other. So now the y coefficients are equal and they both have same symbol. I have to subtract. In subtraction, plus 2x becomes minus 2x, plus 1y becomes minus 1y become plus 1y and plus 1 will become minus 1. So plus 1x and minus 2x gives you minus 1x. So my 1y and 1y get eliminated. As y is eliminated, this method is called elimination method. So minus 2 minus 1 gives you minus 3. Negative negative cancel. X value is equal to 3. So we got the x value. To find y, we have to substitute this x value either in first equation or second equation. So now I will replace this x value in the first equation. So first equation is x minus y is equal to minus 2. X value is 3. So I will replace value of x as 3. And remaining terms I will write as it is. So minus y is equal to minus 2 plus 3 moves to the other side will become minus 3. Minus y is equal to minus 2 minus 3. We all know it is minus 5. So negative negative get cancelled, students. Y value is 5.
So we got x value 3, y value 5. So we assume the fraction as x by y, where x is numerator and the value is 3 and y is denominator and it is 5. So the required fraction is 3 by 5.
Exercise 3.4, second question, second bit. 5 years ago, Nuri was thrice as old as Sonu. 10 years later, Nuri will be twice as old as Sonu. How old are Nuri and Sonu? Here we have two conditions in the question. Based on the two conditions, we will get two linear equations and we are going to solve them using elimination method. As we don't know the Nuri and Sonu age, let us take age of Nuri as x years and Sonu age as y years. So based on the question, first condition is x minus y is equal to 3 into y minus 5. Reason is 5 years ago, as we have taken Nuri age as x, 5 years ago Nuri age will be x minus 5 years and Sonu age is y, 5 years ago her age will be y minus 5. For instance, if your age is 15, what is your age 5 years ago, students? Yeah, 15 minus 5, which is 10. If you are 14 years, 5 years ago your age will be 14 minus 5. Similarly, we don't know Nuri age 5 years ago, her age will be x minus y and Sonu age will be y minus y. Why I am writing 3 times y minus y here in the question? The condition is thrice. Thrice means 3 times. So x minus y is equal to 3 into y minus 5. X minus y is equal to 3 times y is 3y, 3 times 5 is 15. So we will bring all variables together and numbers together. So x minus 3y is equal to minus 15 plus 5. Minus 15 plus 5 is minus 10. So I will take x minus 3y is equal to minus 10 as first equation.
Second condition, 10 years later Nuri will be twice as old as Sonu. So present age of Nuri is x. After 10 years her age will be x plus 10. Twice means 2 times. Sonu age after 10 years will be y plus 10.
So x plus 10 is equal to 2 into y plus 10. 2 into y is 2y, 2 into 10 is 20. We will bring all the variables together and numbers together. So x minus 2y is equal to 10. We will assume it as second equation. Now we are going to solve these two equations using elimination method. So we already know how to solve the elimination method. First we have to arrange x quotients and y quotient in such a way both are one below the other. As the symbols of x are same, we are going to do subtraction. So plus will become minus, minus will become plus and plus will become minus. So plus x minus x get cancelled. So as it is a elimination method, we have eliminated x. Minus 3y plus 2y is minus 1y and minus 10 is minus 20. Negative negative get cancelled. Y will be 20. We assumed Sonu age as y and her age will be 20. Now once we got Sonu age, we are going to replace this y value either in first equation or second equation. I will replace in the first equation. And first equation is x minus 3y is equal to minus 10. As y value is 20, I am going to replace y with 20 is equal to minus 10. X minus 23 is a 60 is equal to minus 10. X is equal to minus 10 plus 60 is 50. So now we got Sonu age as y. We have taken Sonu age as y and our age is 20 years. Nuri age as x and our age is 50 years. Is 3.4, second question, third bit. The sum of the digits of a two-digit number is 9. Also, 9 times this number is twice the number obtained by reversing the order of the digits. Find the number. We have two conditions in this question. Based on the two conditions, we will get two linear equations and we are going to solve them by elimination method. So before going that, we don't know unit digit and 10-digit number. Let us take unit digit or one-digit number as x and 10-digit number as y. If one's digit is x and 10 digit is y, the number obviously will be 10y plus x. Why the number will be 10y plus x? I will take a couple of minutes to explain this, students. For example, if I take 23, 2 is in 10's place and 3 is in 1's place. So I can rewrite this one as 2 into 10 plus 3. So reason is 2 is in 10's place, so 2 is multiplied with 10 and unit place is 3. This is the expansion form of a general number. So similarly, I have taken tens digit as y, so it will be 10y plus x. X is unit digit. This number 10y plus x is the standard form of a two-digit number with units plus x and tens plus y. Now we have two conditions. The sum of two-digit numbers is 9. So we have taken unit plus as x and tens plus as y. So sum will become 9. So x plus y is equal to 9. We'll take it as first equation. There is one more condition in the question. 9 times this number is twice. 9 times this number means 9 number we have taken as 10y plus x. So 9 into 10y plus x is equal to twice the number obtained by reversing the order of the digits. Reversing the order of digits means 10y plus x reverse number will be 10x plus y. 23 reversing the digits will become 32. Similarly, 10y plus x reversing the digits will become 10x plus y. So based on the question, 9 into 10y plus x is equal to 2 into twice 10x plus y. Or minus x plus 8y will become 0. This will be the second equation. Now we got first equation as x plus y is equal to 9 and second equation as minus x plus 8y is equal to 0. Now we are going to solve these two equations using elimination method. I will write first equation x plus y is equal to 9 and second equation minus x plus 8y is equal to 0. So we have to make the either x quotient or y quotient numerically equal. Already the x quotients are same. Based on the symbols, we have to add these two equations. So when I add, plus x minus x will get cancelled, eliminated. And 8y plus 1y will become 9y. And 9 plus 0 is 9. So 9y is equal to 9. Y will become 9 by 9, which is 1. So we got the value of y. Now to get the value of x, we have to substitute this y is equal to 1 either in first equation or second equation. Now I am going to substitute y is equal to 1 in first equation. What is the first equation? X plus y is equal to 9. So x plus 1 is equal to 9. X is equal to 8. So we have taken 1's digit as x and we got 1's digit as 8 and 10's digit as y and the number is 1. So therefore required number is 18. 1 is tens plus 1 and x is unit plus 8. So our required number is 18.